There are two kinds of requirements for understanding the Quran. There are two kinds of requirements. I would even say understanding. Let's just say benefiting from the Quran. There are two kinds of requirements. The first kind of requirements, you can call them academic. Learning the Arabic language is an academic requirement. Studying tafsir is an academic requirement. Understanding the linguistic analysis and the tradition and all of that, all of these are academic requirements. They require you to study. Anything that requires you to study becomes an academic requirement. But more important than the academic requirements, there are certain psychological requirements. I mean, if you don't want to use the word psychological, you can even call them spiritual requirements for benefiting from the Quran. And those are the harder ones. As a matter of fact, somebody who's intelligent can learn the Arabic language in no time. They can study tafsir in no time, memorize even in no time, and understand and know a lot about Allah's book in very little time. But the psychological requirements, the attitude requirements, in really benefiting from the Quran, they are a lifelong struggle. They are something that you can meet at one point in your life and lose at a later point in your life. They are not something you get to keep. They are something you have to fight to maintain. And you have to, more than anything else, you have to fight yourself. I have to fight myself to maintain those requirements. I can tell you that 10 years ago, I knew a lot less about the Qur'an. As the days and the months and the years went by, I knew more and more and more about the Qur'an. And even though in the grand scheme of things, I still know very little about the Qur'an, those original requirements that are psychological in nature, I still have to struggle with those every day. I have to struggle with those. It's not like I graduated and I met those requirements. Like, you know, you take prerequisites in college, you meet the prerequisite and that's it, you don't have to go back to it anymore. It's not the case with Quran. These requirements, they're of a different nature. And the first of those requirements is understanding and reminding oneself every single time, why am I learning this? Why am I reading tafsir? Why am I learning Arabic? Why am I memorizing these ayat? What is the point of all of this? The intention behind all of this? And all of you know the cliche answer, and the cliche answer is, this is so I can have guidance. This is so I can have guidance. That's the, you know, Quran is guidance. We study it for guidance. But that term is used so often that we actually don't understand what that really means. What does it mean that I'm asking Allah for guidance? What that means is that on a given day, every single moment of my day, I will be presented with choices. Should I stay in bed or should I wake up? Should I look there or should I look down? Should I talk back or should I stay quiet? Should I earn my money this way or should I find another job? Should I pursue this or should I leave those friends? Should I hang out with them or should I not hang out? Should I respond back to the text message or not? Choices, all the time, every second of the day, you and I are going to be faced with choices. When we ask Allah for guidance, we are asking Allah for the strength to make the right choices. That Allah empowers us because of His Word to make the right choices. Guidance of the Quran, that's what that means. That's what that means.